It's the 17th and 18th of August 2011. That's right, it's 2 days. I'm going to make this quick video, hopefully, over a couple of days. It's the 17th today. As I work my way up to my 100th cache. At the moment I'm on a circuit around Kenilworth, between Kenilworth and Hunnilly, which is going to take me up to about 98 or so. I've just had number 86. Yeah, that's about it. As you can see, it's a lovely day. It's only about 9:30. The guest house I'm staying in has breakfast rather early, so I'm out early as a result. Now, yes, I've got my OS map here. I've got a compass, if you can see that, and I don't know which way it's going. So I'm very prepared. I've also got my phone with my geocache stuff in my pocket, and an application that translates my coordinates into grid references, which is the useful thing here. I'll leave it at that for the moment. I'll check back in soon. Okay, bye. Hello, it's 12:20 and I've just been through Hunnilly, Hazley Knob and what was the other one? Bosell, with apologies to all of the five residents or so that live there if I've mispronounced the name. Okay, I'm just about, hopefully, to find my 90th cache, so I thought I'd take you with me. It's just a simple one in the base of a tree, apparently, so I'm guessing that it might be somewhere in here. Aha! This is a cache called Jaipur. Be back for cache number 91 in a bit. Number 91. Stump, stump. There it is. This is called Fundy. Okay, I'll be back for number 92. Number 92. This one's called Jodhpur, and the clue is left logs. And there's some logs over there, so I'm thinking they look good. Well, there's quite a lot of left logs. Okay, might be looking for a bit then. Okay, this one's a bit harder than the rest of the ones in this series. Oh, they're under here. Yeah, they're under here. That's the very first log you see when you come. Yep. Okay, back for number 93. Number 93 is called the Gap, and I've just seen two logs with a gap in it. So that's looking promising. Not quite sure what size this cache is, actually, come to think of it. So it could be any size at all. Let's have a quick look. Small cache. That's not a cache, that's a brick. That looks like a pencil. I wonder if it's still here in that case. Ah, yes, someone else didn't find it 3 days ago. Oh, that's a shame. Okay, well, on to the next one then. Okay, revised 92 is called Hot Pot, and I can see a pot down here. So, let's hope it's hot. Oh, well, one of the logs mentioned a decoy. I guess that's the decoy. Back in a bit then. After crawling through some undergrowth for a while, and getting a few more stings, I found another thing that looks like a pot, so let's hope second time lucky. Oh. It's a rather sadistic cache. Series of crashes. Here we go. Hey. Okay. Back for I've lost count now. 94, I guess. Bye. Number 94, two gates to nowhere. The clue says just on the left of the wooden, just on the right of the wooden gate. Careful, thorny bushes. So this should be fun. The things I do for geocaching. That'd be a branch, and that'd be my head. That'd be the thorny bush. Let's see if I can get that out of the way. Ah! There it is. Okay, I'll be back for number 95. My scrapes feel a little better now. Number 95. Permanent vacation. The ultimate penalty. The hint says to go around the tree. Ooh, I think we've already found where it's going to be. That's a good easy one. I like it. Number 96. Oh, okay. This is a cache called Alpaca. He's not an alpaca, of course, he's a goat. Look at him, there's a horse over there. There are some alpacas around, but I can't see them. It's the name of the cache. The cache clue itself is keep us posted. It's not dangerous. And there's a danger sign next to a post. So let's give that a try. Oh, hang on a second, there's a muggle coming on the bike. This is a really high muggle area, actually. So I'm having to watch out. What's that? It could be bubbly. No, that's a cache. Hey. Okay, back for 97. Number 97. Mamma Mia. Or Mere, since it's named after some kind of M-E-R-E feature of the landscape. I gave up on this one last night because there were too many gnats around, but I've come back armed with longer trousers, walking boots, and insect repellent. So let's give it a go. God, this is going to be camera in the river syndrome, isn't it? There's something under there. Let's have a look. Be a leaf. Apparently my camera has decided that 2 gigabytes of video is quite enough boring geocache videos for now. Anyway, I've given up on the Mamma Mia cache. A good look around, but I cannot find it, and the GPS is not good enough to figure out which of the many trees behind me, rather behind you, is the right one. Anyway, behind me is Kenilworth Castle. I'm going to turn around so I can make sure this is in shot. It's a really, really nice castle. Old remains. Okay, that's it for now. Give 97, 98, 99 a go tonight then, I suppose. Number 97, Humpty Dumpty. Because it's in a wall, you see. I've already found it. Yeah. Check back soon for 98. Number 98. It was just in here. It's very clever. Covered in cobwebs at the time as well. Okay. See you back for 99. Good morning, it's now the 18th. I gave up on finding caches last night, but I got an email this morning from one of the cache authors of one I didn't find yesterday saying that it was indeed disappeared, and he's now replaced it. So thank you to the Gaps cache owner. And I'm on my way there. It's 8.30 and checkout's at 10, so I'm being quite speedy. Number 99, and I've just found it. Here's where it should have been. There's the gap. And it was under the... well, it is now under the brick. Okay, I'm up to Warwick University for number 100. I will see you there roughly now. Or here, whichever one I was supposed to say. Hello, I'm in the process of getting number 100. What's that you say? There's no cache around here. I'm in the middle of a courtyard. Ah, it's a virtual cache. I've got Emily in front of a computer somewhere, in Oxford, I think. And about to take a photo of me. So, there we go. 100 caches. Yay! Now, I'm off to Ayacon for the rest of the weekend. I'm going to put that stuff in a different video, of course, since I imagine the overlap between caches and anime fans is probably fairly small. Okay, see you later. Bye.